Hello students, welcome in our second session of our lesson, A Different Kind of School. Students, I hope you are all fine at your houses with your parents. Okay, and students, before this we have seen the whole lesson, A Different Kind of School, in which we have learned that why that school is to be different, because they teach there the different skills, how to be a responsible person, and how to be take care of others, right? So let's see these question and answers in this session. A different kind of school, working with a text, and NCERT book Honeysuckle, page number 62 and 63. So first question is, put these sentences from the story in the right order and write them out in a paragraph. Don't refer to the text. Okay, so the question is, you have to put the sentences from the story in the right order and put them into the right paragraph. Okay, so let's see what are the given sentences are. I shall be so glad when today is over. Having a leg tied up and hoping that on a crutch is almost fun, I guess. I don't think I will mind being deaf for a day. At least not much then, but being blind is so frightening. Only you must tell me about things. Let's go for a little walk. The other bad days can't be half as bad as this. So these are the given sentence, so let's make a paragraph meaningful. Students, here look at that, I made an answer for you. Let's go for a little walk. Only you must tell me about things. I shall be so glad when today is over. The other bad days can't be half as bad as this. Having a leg tied up and hoping about on crutch is almost fun. I guess I don't think I will mind being deaf for a day, at least not much, but being blind is so frightening. So like that, you can arrange the whole sentences into the para. Okay, look at that question number B. Answer the following questions. Question 1. Why do you think the writer visited Miss Beam's school? And the probable answer is, so many people have talked or written about Miss Beam's school. So, visited the school to get overall experience about the school. So, author visited the school to get overall experience about the school. Then question number 2, what was the game that every child in the school had to play? Every child in the school has to play as given the task for the role of being blind, deaf, dumb, lame, and injured once in a term. It was a kind of a game to make them aware about misfortune. Right, students? Okay, so look at that third question. Each term, every child has one blind day, one lame day. Complete the line. Which day was the hardest? Why was it the hardest? Answer: each term, every child has one blind day, one lame day, one deaf day, and one injured day, and one dumb day also. Okay, so blind day was the hardest day because the students were afraid they might fall down or hurt themselves, and therefore it was very hardest day. Question number 4, what was the purpose of these special days? The purpose of these special days was to make the children appreciate misfortune. Thus, they learn to help those who suffered from such a misfortunes. This is the main purpose of these special days. Students, here there is a next question, a different kind of school. Okay, here you have to match the words and phrases with their meanings in the box below. And look at that, the words given are homesick, practically in pain, it pains me, appreciate, thoughtless, exercise, relief, and ghastly. So the words that are given to match in the box are almost, then it hurts me, terrible, test the strength of, understanding the difficulties, wanting to be home, a welcome change, not very caring, etc. So now look at that pair. Homesick means what? Wanting to be home. Practically, almost, it pains me, it means it hurts me. Appreciate, it means understanding the difficulties. Thoughtless, not very caring. Okay, then exercise, test the strength of, relief, a welcome change. Ghastly means terrible, very horrible like. Okay, then look at that next question. Reword these lines from the story. Let's first of all, we will read the lines, and then we have to write the meaning, means what is that thing behind this sentence in our own sentence. Okay, so I read first. I had heard a great deal about Miss Beam's school. Then second one is, Miss Beam was all that I had expected, middle age, full of authority. Third is, I went to the window which overlooked a large garden. Fourth one is, we cannot bandage the children's mouth, so they really have to exercise their willpower, right? So first of all, we will reword the first line. I had heard a great deal about Miss Beam school. Then the probable answer is, the writer had heard good reviews about the teaching methods at Miss Beam school. Okay, we have just changed the words among these lines, but the meaning of the same line, or you can say sentences, is quite similar. Then look at that second one. Miss Beam was all that I had expected, middle age and full of authority. You can write like this. The writer found that Miss Beam to be middle age and authoritative woman. Okay, look at that third one. I went to the window which overlook a large garden, and it will be like the writer look out of the window and saw a large garden. Then look at that fourth one. We cannot bandage the children's mouth, so they really have to exercise their willpower. The children's mouths cannot be bandaged, so they have to learn to keep quiet. Like that, you can reword these sentences, students. Look at that next one. Question number C on page number 64. Here, given below is a words, or you can say, you can find out from a dictionary. Look at it carefully and answer. Find a word which means the same as ghastly. Ghastly means terrible. Write down the word in two meanings. Yes, okay. So ghastly means terrible. Terrible, it means to be fearful or horrible. Okay, then find a word meaning a part of the school year. Yes, it is a term. Part of the school year means term. Okay, a fixed length of time or in a school year are the another possible meanings of that word. Then find a word that means examination, and the word is test. For examination we use often the test. So to look at something to see if it is correct or will work properly, we often took the test. To ask someone questions, it is also defined as text. Okay, then look at that next question, question number 2. Now make list of, for what, all the words on the page that begin with TERR. So you have to write the words begin with a TERR. Okay, look at that. Terrace, terrible, terror, then territory, terrain, terrorist, terrestrial, and terrifying are the words begin with a TERR. Then 5 words that may follow the last word on the page, that. So like that, the words are like those, there, the, than, and this. You can say possessive words are used, then write down your own meaning of the word thank. Then write down the meaning given in the dictionary. Okay, so the meaning is be for any help and glad. To say we are grateful to someone for any help. So whenever we thank another people, we say we are very grateful, right? Okay, so like that you can answer these questions, students. Okay, here there is a poem given in your page number 65. First of all, just read this poem. It is to understand you how blind people were suffer from. Let's read this poem. All but blind, in his chambered hole, groups for worms, the four-clawed mole. All but blind in the evening sky, that hooded bat wheels softly by. All blind in the burning day, the barn owls blunders on her way. And blind as were these three to me, so blind to someone it must be. Okay, so like that, this poem is given in your page of your textbook. You can read it. It is because that how that blind people suffer from morning to evening. They were totally neglected by the people, and they are thrown out of that window. Means they are thrown out of the window of society, like that I want to say. Okay, so this is the poem about the blind people hardness. Look at that next question. A different kind of school. Okay, and make a short list of things you find difficult to do. For example, look at that, turning a somersault, then threading a needle. Compare your list with the others in the class. Can you explain with you why you find these things difficult to do? Yes, we can do this activity in our class too. But doing these things are really very difficult, because it needs while threading that needle, we need concentration, we need perfection, and while turning a summer wall, we need to be physically fit. Okay, students, so that you can perform this activity in the presence of your parents too, right? Look at next question. Look at your hands carefully. Now write down for each finger one action for which that finger is particularly important. For example, the second into bracket or index finger helps to hold the knife down firmly when cutting. Okay, so first finger is used to see that to warn somebody and point something. First finger, right? Then middle finger to hold the things, right finger for putting one ring, and little finger for making the list. Okay, like that. Here all the exercise of yours is finished. Okay, students, write it in your notebook. Thank you for hearing, and solve all the questions. Be safe at your houses. Thank you.